Okay. Akira's heartbeat is stable. Looks like the worst is over. But to be completely honest, it's a miracle they made it out in the first place.
Thanks to Dr. Calvert. He's a miracle worker.
I can't take all the credit. Our Akira is quite special.
There is still a chance of infection. Run another check, and make sure there's no sign of mutation.
Brenda, we can take it from here. Go back to HQ, and let everyone know Akira is safe.
But, Doctor...
Brenda, please. I'll be here to make sure everything goes smoothly. And either way, I have more than enough work to keep me busy around here for quite some time. Thank you.
I see. Very well. I'll see you at the station, Doctor.
Brenda and the Commander are both on it. Akira literally couldn't be in better hands. Brenda gives even the Commander a run for his money when it comes to all that science stuff. And what happened to Akira wasn't your fault. Jenna was more powerful than anyone could have expected. Trust me, even the Commander didn't see it coming. Akira did what he did because it's his duty as a Neuron officer to protect you, no matter what. But duty is one thing. To go that far for you, Akira must really have wanted to keep you safe. You've both been through so much, and Akira's taken it harder than you have. But putting his sister first? I guess that's brotherly love. Huh. Having someone you'd do anything to protect like that must... Oh, never. That's right. We got a report back from the high-tech forensics department. That huge thing you fought at the mall? Apparently, it wasn't a Chimera at all. They've never seen anything that wasn't a Chimera spread data corruption like that. They're all completely stumped. Well, if they figure anything out, you'll know about it as soon as I do. Beyond that, we're putting all our effort into finding out where Jenna went. She completely vanished 20 years ago, and now she's back. And with that thing in tow... Not even the Commander has any clue what she's after. And that's a rarity for him. As if your hands weren't full enough with the Chimeras, right? Jenna's not going to make things any easier. Brenda!
I'm glad I found you two. I just got back from the lab. He's going to be fine. Akira is... shockingly resilient, really. Akira's still under anesthesia, but why don't you go pay a visit? The facility is usually off-limits to outside personnel, but this time, I think we can make an exception. Take your time and collect yourself. Find me in the infirmary when you're ready.
Brenda, thank you. Well, that's a load off my mind. I've got to get back to work. Let me know if you need anything, okay?
Yeah, our brother's gonna be fine. However, just gonna point this out. It's right here. Yeah. Let me just go see if I what clothing items I got. Be sure. Let's see. Oh, there's somebody here to talk to. Mary.
Keeping up the good work, I see.
Yeah.
There's something we need to talk about. Can you spare me an ear, preferably two?
Sure. What is it?
So, I have to confess. Before that... Oh, wow! It's a perfect fit! And it really suits you. Ooh! Oh, Isn't it great? It's like I'm looking at the real Lappy. Speaking of...
Are you going to tell me that you're a Lappy?
Right. Something I have to tell you.
Because we already know that.
It's about Lappy. He's been me. I am Lappy. There it is. I'm sorry. I know. I should have told you earlier.
Did you forget how we met?
You know, you are handling this a lot better than I expected. I thought you were gonna freak out. Oh, it can't be. How could you, Marie? Oh, I never knew the difference. Nothing.
No.
Okay.
We knew. You forget how we met.
Before I came to Neuron, I was a traffic officer. That's how I became Lappy. I'd put on that suit and walk around, and everyone would smile at me. Oh, best feeling ever. And everyone here always looks so tired, you know, so... Well, I figured a visit from Lappy would get them smiling again. It went so well the first time, so I just kept doing it, and now look, Lappy's a part of the Neuron family. Which brings me to our problem. Last week, I put the suit on, fell flat on my face, and twisted my ankle. I know. And now Brenda says to give Lappy a rest. I wonder how Brenda figured out it was me. Anyway, I can't be Lappy again until my stupid leg is healed up. Meanwhile, Neuron gets gloomier and gloomier. And at this rate, the whole office will be plunged into endless darkness. We cannot... let that happen. And so, in the meantime, I want you to be Lappy in my place. It is the perfect plan. Nobody knows it's me in there. Just wear it and just talk to anyone who could use a friendly smile. I'm sure they're going to love you. Okay, don't worry. Just think of all the good you'll be doing. Yes, okay, I'm getting gloomy vibes from all around the station. First of all, yes, the B2 elevators. There's gotta be people in need of a Lappy-sized pick-me-up. What are you waiting for? Go turn those frowns around so there are smiles instead.
No, not the most appropriate mission for me to be doing while my brother's in the hospital, but it works. I wanted to see clothing that I had, so I'll do that after I finish Lappy's lament. Hello, Mike.
Marie, what are you... hey, Lappy. Carefree as ever, I see.
I mean, look at that face. Of course I'm carefree.
Could you be a little less here?
Can I bark?
Huh? You want to know what's troubling me?
Yes.
Well, I don't know if talking about it'll help, but sure. You know, I really love animals, especially cats. But protecting cats from Redshift isn't part of the job. So I can't get clearance to do it. I gotta do something about it, but I don't want to get the sack. But then I imagine all the poor cats out there, sick and scared in some alley. It keeps me awake at night. Huh? Really? You know a place where cats can stay safe? Wow, I had no idea there was somewhere like that out in Mason Forest. You've got to take me sometime. Ah, If too many people go to see it, it'll attract too much attention. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. But it's a load off my mind just knowing it's out there. Hey, Marie, hey, Lappy, thanks a lot for listening.
Does she really think nobody knows that it's her?
I heard everything. Oh, that's one more smile we'll see around the station today. On to the next troubled soul.
Can I go pick up the item?
We're in the infirmary on level B2. This'll be the happiest place on the Ark in no time.
I wish you would just tell me where they are so I could go instead of like giving me a long explanation about them and their problems. It's right here.
Oh, Marie, sorry, Lappy. I'm kind of going through some stuff right now. Can you please just let me be?
How about no?
Are you trying to cheer me up?
Kind of my job today.
I appreciate the thought. In fact, it's my partner Avery I'm all wound up about.
What'd he do?
Avery is really energetic, which is great, but just look at me. Not so much. I can't jump back into action right away, after a mission. Hell, I get winded just standing up for a long time. To be honest, sometimes I'm not even sure why they chose me for Neuron. But Avery won't hear any of it. I really can't keep going on like this. I've tried to tell her, but...
Oh, it's a girl.
Come on, you know her. I literally can't get a word in edgewise. There's no way I'll ever keep up with her.
You want me to talk to her?
Please.
Is that her?
Oh,
that's a dude.
Lappy, would you please tell Avery for me? Don't tell her, but, indirectly. She's probably in the break room. And thanks for doing what I can't.
Barf. You're really, really good. Hey, Avery. I have something to tell you. The news is on.
Hey, Lappy! What's up? Taking a breather?
Kinda.
Yes, you're here for an energy drink? Something like that? Wow, I bet it's exhausting to wear that thing all day.
Probably is.
Your little hat. Wearing your little hat all day must be exhausting, Lappy. But forget it. You're thirsty, yeah? Well, today I recommend a nice alkali coca. One sip and you will literally burst with energy like boom, boom, bam! I've had three. Woo! Come on, try one and see! Oh, you didn't come here for a drink, did you?
Let me talk.
Wait, what's that, boy? There's a Neuron officer lacking self-confidence. Says he can't keep up with me?
Burf, burf.
Oh, you're talking about Mitsuru, aren't you? Yeah,
why am I doing dog noises? I'm an idiot.
We got back from Ark Mall.
Better than nothing.
I noticed. But, bending over backwards so he can keep up won't do us any good either. And if anything, I've been overdoing it, hoping some of my energy would rub off. I guess I've been pretty hard on him.
Oh my.
Sorry to get kind of dark there. I get wound up pretty easily.
That was dark.
I'll try to pace myself so I won't push Mitsuru too hard.
Thank you. A heartfelt gift. It's a warm cola.
Hopefully it'll cheer Mitsuru up.
I'm on the case. I'm at 30%, so that's not bad. A third of it's done now. We're gonna be over.
Hi, Marie. Dang it. Hi, Lappy. So, what'd she say? What's this? Alkali cocoa?
No.
Oh, so Avery was just trying to motivate me by acting so wild all the time, huh?
No.
I never noticed that she even cared. And here I am just moping around alone. That settles it. I've got to get stronger. I won't drag Avery down anymore. But first, I need to apologize to her for the misunderstanding. In person. I feel a little braver already. Thanks to you, Oof, Lappy! Oh, it was so close.
You got it. Wait a minute. And the fact that I can move is kinda dumb. Last person to help, it's probably going to be a big one because we have 40% to go. So, training room, youth. Oh yeah, we saved the cat during the last mission. So who, first things first, item. Also, I like the fact that everybody is trying to keep appearances like, oh no, we don't know you were Lappy. We don't know who Lappy is, Mary. Great to see you. Have you been through my thoughts with a Lappy Blaster? No? Well, let me know when you do. Oh, I can't upgrade my thing as long as I'm doing this side quest. God damn it. I'll come back later. Sup? Oh, it's Jin.
What is it? Oh, it's you, Marie. Right. Lappy, yeah. I don't see you down here much.
Murph.
Look, I'm in the middle of training. Whatever it is, could you save it?
Murph.
Hey, I told you I'm training. Could you please come back later?
Okay, I'm not. Okay, Jesus.
What is it? You are extra persistent today.
Burf, burf. Burf, burf, burf. Why am I still barking?
Down here training,
so I'm an idiot.
What's it to you? Alright, look.
Yeah, Lappy talks like a person. Why the hell am I barking? I just realized that.
Akira's still unconscious after what went down at the mall. With the captain gone, that's on me.
Not really, it's on more on me, but sir.
Well, that means while we're on the job, his kids are my responsibility. I promised him I'd take care of them. Now, I don't know if I'm strong enough to keep that promise. But now, he's gone. And I'm not any stronger. I couldn't even catch up to Jenna in the first place. Akira could, and look what I let happen. I couldn't face Max if he came back. Not like this. So, I'll do anything to get stronger. And fast. I have to keep everybody safe. I can't let him down. I know I don't have the experience or the skill that he had. I figure maybe I can make up for it with sheer effort. Wait, what's that? What?
Wait, am I offering to fight?
You wanna spar? Well, thanks for the laugh. I don't know, but seriously, you've never lifted an ex-baton in your life, right? Oh. That stance. Yeah, I see. You're serious about this. Oh. Okay, then. But I'm warning you. I don't hold back. Not even in practice.
So,
come on. Show me what you've got.
Am I supposed to win? Jesus! Okay, I am supposed to win, not to lose. I thought I had to lose or something, but no. Also, he's very fast. If you allow him to get any space, he's gonna whoop your ass. He was about to whoop mine, but I won. No, I didn't. Jesus.
Wow, amazing. You can hold your own, even wearing that thing. You know, I haven't had a thrashing like that since last time I sparred with the captain. Oh, yeah, you know, I do feel a little better. Oh, I gotta say, this has been an eye-opening training session, Lappy. Thanks. I really mean it.
And with that, my job is done. Lappy arms. Arms from the Lappy suit, quite flexible one of the 6 happy items. Collect them all and see what happens. Okay, so we have the hat and the arms. What do we need? The legs? The heads?
Hi, it's me. Sounds like Neuron HQ is officially trouble-free. Now, head on back here.
Am I gonna get teleported? That's what I thought.
Fantastic work. Oh, top-notch cheering up. Really. Even I could probably learn a thing or two about being Lappy from you. Probably. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Just don't go asking anything. Don't go to people and bark. It's weird when I did it.
Well, I'm resting real hard to make sure my leg heals up soon, so don't you worry.
Anything else, partner?
Wow, you're really motivated. But if you get too good at my job, where does that leave me?
Jobless, probably. Unemployment line, but I'm still...
I wasn't just imagining you as my bitterest, most heinous rival or anything like that.
Oh! I got so wrapped up in spreading cheer that I forgot about all those case reports I need to alphabetize. See you.
And I see you. So before we head out, and we're not gonna head out of this episode, and I'm gonna have to like edit stuff out because there already is stuff that I need to edit out here at the end. But there's really nothing to do, or I don't like the hats; they look way too big on her head. We only have this. Okay. Okay, so I guess. That'll be it. Wait. Let me check. Do we have any different hairstyles? No. I guess that'll be it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. We only did really the Lappy mission, but it took us about 20 minutes. Join me next episode as we're gonna go with Brenda. We're gonna talk to Brenda and see our brother. And I'm gonna stay here, not approach her, just in case. There she is. So, I'll see you guys then.